The following interview is brought to you by ggChronicle.com. Esports news, coverage, opinion.
我们会在几乎所有的时间都维持有 Oracle 这个视野，然后我们会把所有视野不好，当对方会造成走位失误，我会强退一线，然后逼着对方来防守。对方需要经过防守的路线的时候，我会通知我队友说，
Usually we start off with an oracle and clear out their view, and then we also put down wards. So when the opponent comes in from the other side, then I look for their misposition and I tell my team I'm going to grab this area and I'm going to grab them.
Hey, so tomorrow you guys are going to be facing M5, who are a very heavily favored team. What do you think your chances are against them?
说觉得我们打M5的胜率怎么样？100。100。DV says 100%, we're confident.
A couple of months ago, you were regarded as probably the best team in the world when we didn't actually in the Western world see any games of you. And then the performances from our side, what came over was that you weren't doing so well. Were you kind of pleased with that and thought, okay, now we can lay low and just fight back and show them that we are the best in the world at the championships?
他说几个月以前我们不是曾经是好像很强吗？ 然后为什么最近的线上赛好像都没有打得很理想？我们是为什么会这样？我们在这几个月的时间，我们密集的训练，为了这次 Season 2
的 championship，然后在这组中，我们参加的线上比赛都是为了找到最适合我们team跟最适合我们队伍的风格。然后，所以我们在线上比赛并不能表现得非常漂亮跟非常突出。那一方面也是因为韩国队伍真的非常优秀，然后才会造成我们大家看到这个情况。
So we actually played a couple of tournaments online against some Korean teams, and throughout these online tournaments, we were testing out our strategies and see which composition was the best for us. And because we weren't really familiar with the strategies, that caused some of our losses. Also because Korean teams are really, really good teams, and that's why it seemed like we had a really bad loss against our online tournaments.
Lil Balls in particular, with your NA experience in the past and your experience with CLG, do you think that that kind of knowledge came over when you were joining Taipei Assassins and helped you guys become the team that you are and your knowledge of the tournament scene?
Okay. 当台湾的伺服器开始的时候, 并没有这么多的玩家在台湾伺服器上面玩，所以有NA的经验当然是会比较好的。然后我们有把一些战术跟一些选角上面的策略会带过来这边。When
the Taiwanese server first opened, there weren't a lot of players that actually played, so it was really useful for me, well, Little Balls, to bring in some of the NA strategies and teach my team how to play more Western.
So up on stage, you mentioned that you see Moscow 5 as a mentor. Have they like trained you, or what exactly does that mean?
就是说有点像你那时候不是说他觉得像什么，有点像老师吗？他说这是什么意思？谁？他说他你没有跟他们练习过吗，还是怎么样吗？为什么？我们没有办法跟 Moscow 5练习过，因为 pin 的关系，他们在欧洲伺服器，然后我们会顶着300多pin的延迟，我们没有办法跟他们练习。那 他们不断的创新战术跟带给整个游戏环境的刺激，我想是非常值得我们学习的，这也是我们特别尊敬他们的原因。We
were never actually be able to practice with them because of the ping from Europe to Taiwan server. We really respect them because they're always creative, they bring up new strategies and bring good games into the tournament. So that's why we really, really respect them.
All right, we'll open it up for any additional questions. We don't have to go in order. So anybody have any follow-ups?
Yeah, I have a question for Lil Balls. Way back, you used to play a lot with the Counter Logic Gaming players, and I wanted to know what your relationship was like with them these days and what you thought of their play yesterday in the group stages.
Yeah.
I
was kind of disappointed and sad for them by yesterday's performance. I know they can play a lot better, and it seemed like they were really, really nervous.
Mac Noon is widely regarded as one of the best top laners in the game, and Stanley as well is, you know, considered in that upper echelon. Did that pressure of playing against Mac Noon, did that result in some of the lane swaps that we saw? And then also, Stanley, how was your experience playing against Mac Noon?
That question a bit with how he feels about laning against Mac Noon.
Just whether or not coming into the game you strategized to pressure Mac Noon in particular, or what Stanley's opinions were of that matchup.
He didn't really have any thoughts into it. He just played normally, like how he would play against any other top lane.
Any other questions?
One more.
With growing with the League of Legends scene and how it's been growing in Taiwan, how does the community react to you guys and your play? Are you guys like mini celebrities in your areas?
我们在台湾来讲其实我们是都是蛮有名气的选手然后我们所有的粉丝都给予我们所有的支持然后可能是因为之前的线上赛我们表现的没有特别好所以会有一些负面的消息出来所以其实我们这次比赛就为了证明我们的实力到哪里
Our fans are actually really supportive, and we're pretty well known in Taiwan and also in some Asian countries. And we're because of our online events, online tournaments, we didn't perform that well. So some negative news and some negative response they received from the fans. So now we finally proved to them that we can play as well as they wanted us to do.
All right, last call. Any additional questions for the Taipei Assassins? All right, well, thanks, guys. Thanks so much.
Thank you very much.